residents. My name is Ruben Ezekiel from First Factory Fund, ISTC. Today, I'll be taking you on global and local network. Global and local network. But before we continue, what is that word network? Networking is connecting two or more computers together to share data. Two or more computers connected together to share data. And that is what we call networking. Now, today we are going to be discussing about global and local network. First and foremost, let's discuss about local network. Local network are a type of network that is within a building or a local area. Say, for instance, from one office to the other, from one building to the other, from one locality to another. That is what we call local networking. The type of connection that we use with cable. Two computers connected together with cable. That one is a local area network. But let me make an illustration on the board. Let's put this one as one computer, the other one, this computer one, computer two. The two of them are connected together with a cable. Computer two. This is computer one, while this one is computer two. So this type of connection is local area network. Local area network, in which two computers are connected together with the aid of a cable. Now, when we talk about global area network, we are talking about a wide area network, a type of network that does not require cable, that required radio communication. Some of them require server link, server network to connect them together. We have different types of network. One, we have what we call peer-to-peer network. This peer-to-peer network is still a type of local area network in which we can easily use cable to connect computers together. But when we are talking about global area network, a very wide type of network that required radio communication, and that is one of the differences between a local and a global network. A local network is within a locality, within a building, or between one office to the other. While that of global network required radio communication because it does not require cable. These network components have some features in which we are going to be discussing today. One, the computer that are connected together, computer and similar devices are called node. Node, that is N-O-D-E. This one can connect about 1,000 computers together. Let's assume this a node. Thousands of computers are connected to it. Just like this. Like this. Different type of computers are connected. They share the data from this node here. They share their own data from this node. Even sometimes we can even share printer from the same node at the same time. So that is what we are talking about wireless network. Another thing is network software that run on each computer and enable it to communicate with other computer on the network. That's another feature. Then another feature of that wireless network is network hardware that connects computers together include network cable, and other devices. Now, when we talk about a wide area network, one, One means wide area network. This type of network does not require cable. This type of network required radio communication. That is, take for instance, somebody from a particular state to another state. That is wide area network. It does not require cable. This type of network required a lot of radio communication. It is wireless. It is different from that of local area network, in which you can easily connect one cable from one place to the other. Or you can also use any type of cable to connect from one computer to the other. The world LAN local area network is limited to a particular area. Take for instance, from office A to office B, or from one building to the other. That is local area network. But the wide area network does not require cable. It required radio communication. Then we have types of network hardware. Like one, we have network adapter card. Network adapter card. Network adapter card. That's one of the network hardware. We have network hub. Network hub. Then we have network cable. These are hardware, network hardware that we can use. All this one fall under local area network. Because why? It requires cable, it requires hub, and at the same time, adapter card. But when we talk about global network, a global network from one particular state to another, it requires radio communication. Sometimes it's required server in which it communicates from one state to another, because it is not possible to use cable for such a communication. So in that aspect, wide area network required server network in which cable is not required. Now, this morning, as we'll be discussing global and local network, as I've mentioned earlier, I said global network is a type of network that does not require cable. What it requires is radio communication. That is a connection from Lagos State to Ogun State, or from Anambra to Enugu State. So all those ones require what we call global networking. In this global networking, one can easily get a lot of information from the network. Why? Because it does not require cable. Because their distance is very far. They are not as close as that of local area network. Local area network is the one that requires cable, in which one can easily see what is going on in the other computer. But that of global network is a different one. And at the same time, I said network, we have wireless network that does not require cable. And this, on this network of this wireless network, the computer that are connected together, and they use different devices such as node to connect to share information together. Network software that run on each computer and enable it to communicate with other computer on the network. Now, if you are sharing information on the network, especially if it's a global one, this type of networking share information to a very long distance, a distance that does not require cable. In this type of network, a lot of information can be shared. One can be in any place and it will still share the same information from the same network because it is global. While the one on local area network requires cable. And we have also different type of cable that can be used for the land area network. While we have the coaxial cable. This coaxial cable can be used for a LAN networking with other accessories used together to connect the local area network. The local area network can also be shared in the same office. They can also share printer together. There's no need for you to get about 4 or 5 printer to get information. Once you are on local area network, you can share information from the same printer. Once it is connected together through a cable. The same information can be printed from the same printer in as much as you are within the same area. And that is what we call peer-to-peer network, in which everybody shares information from the same network. Because why? They have what we call this up, that is where the information is being passed to other computers. We have computer 1, computer 2, computer 3, computer 4, computer 5, computer 6. All these 6 computers can share information from this hub. All of them will share the same information from this hub, which means this is the information source where the information has been passed to other places. See, from this computer 1 to computer 6, they get their information from here. Then, if you talk about the global networking, that one uses radio communication. In this type of communication, it does not require cable like that of the local area network. This one, they use what we call radio communication or the server. They get their information from here, from the server here. So their information is coming right from the server. And this one can go as long as millions of miles, because the information is from the server and it's wireless. It's not like the local area network. Now, what are the differences between the local area network and the global area network? Differences between global and local area network. One, global. It covers It covers a long distance. That is one on the area of global networking. While that of LAN, local area network, it covers a particular locality. Take for instance, from one office to another. It can also be connected with a cable. Number two, on the global side, it uses server or radio communication. Why? That of LAN, it uses cable to connect. To connect the computers together. And three its range from one state to another. While that of local area network, it covers just a short distance. You can see the differences between the global and the local area network. One, on the area of global networking, it covers a long distance. As I've said before, I said global area network does not require cable. It requires a very long distance where it does not need cable. So it covers a long distance. While that of local area network is cover a particular locality. Take for instance, from one building to another. That is from one building, from building A to building B. That is local area network. And sometimes it can be done with cable. You can use different type of cable. I've mentioned before, I said you can use coaxial cable for the connection. That is local area network. Number two, it uses server or radio communication. That is global networking. It uses server or radio communication. While that of local area network uses cable to connect the computers together. Even on this local area network, they can use the same printer. They can share information from the same printer. Like two to three computers can share information or print out information from one printer. That is local area network. Why? The third one is it ranges from one state to another, which means it covers a very long distance. Why? That of local area network cover just a very short distance. Now, from what we have discussed so far, you can see the differences between the global and the local area network. The global area network covers a very long distance where it does not require cable. But that of local area network covers a particular locality and it requires cable. And at the same time, I said there are also wireless network. Wireless network in which it does not need a cable. This wireless network, I said, the computer that are connected together that uses different type of devices that are called nodes. This node is where other computers share their information from. That is, this one is the node now. That is where they share their information from. Network software that run on each computer and enable it to communicate with other computers on the network. Once the computer is connected to that network, it will share the same information with others. At the same time, network hardware that connects computer together include network cable and other devices. Then we have network hardware. We have network hardware. The network hardware includes one, we have them as network adapter. That is one, network adapter card. That is number one. Two, the first one is network adapter card. The second one is network hub. That is one of the network hardware that we use. The third one is network cable. We have different type of communication cable that you can use for your network hardware. As I was saying, I've made mention of network hardware. Under the network hardware, we have network adapter card, which we use. At the same time, network hub. Also, we have network cable. I've made mention of coaxial cable the other time. We also have special unshielded twisted cable that we also use for networking. This type of cable are specially made for networking. So in conclusion, today we are able to mention what networking is all about. We differentiate between global and local area network, and we are able to discuss most of the network, the networking components, that is the networking hardware and that of the wireless network. So at this point, we have been able to differentiate between the two of them, global and local area network. Global area network required a very long distance in which you use radio communication or server, while that of local area network makes use of cable, and the distance is not all that far. It is between one office to the other, or between one locality to another, using different type of cable. So at this point, by the time, I know you have learned one or two things today, by the time we'll be meeting again on the next class, we'll be discussing something new again. Thank you very much.